never failing. I know that all things are working for my good. Yeah, she's intentional, never failing. All things are working
for my good.
Cause she's intentional,
she's intentional.
Hey, and it's never failing,
never failing.
All things are working for my good.
God, my sisters and my brothers in Christ Jesus, hallelujah. I thank you for tuning in to the broadcast tonight. Tonight is Friday, Fire Friday. Oh my God, come on somebody. Are you ready to call fire? Are you ready to locate the enemy that has located you? Oh my God, hallelujah, people of God. I tell you tonight, it's a privilege, it's an honor to be in the presence of a mighty people, a chosen people, a royal people, hallelujah, God's people. Hallelujah, God's people. Oh my God. There's no people like God's people, huh? A victorious people. Even though we can be in the midst of the battle, we're still victorious. Even though we have to ride through the storm, we're still coming out victorious. Come on, somebody. Oh my God. Hallelujah, people of God, on tonight. Hallelujah. I thank God once again, hallelujah, to come on the airwaves and speak to Polk County. Hallelujah. Can somebody be a witness in Winter Haven? Can somebody be a witness tonight in Lake Wales? Can somebody be a witness tonight in Haines City? Oh, yeah. And then I'm calling on Lakeland tonight. Can somebody be a witness to knowing that we are a chosen people, hallelujah, a mighty people, a victorious people, hallelujah, regardless of how it looks, regardless of how it sounds, we are, hallelujah, children of the Most High God. I'd rather be a son than to be a bastard. I'd rather be a child of the living God than to be a castaway. Come on, somebody. Praise God. Give God thanks tonight because he chose you. You didn't choose him, but he chose you on tonight. Can somebody call fire? Woo, glory, hallelujah. See, the enemy don't like the word, hallelujah. So when your mouth opens, and that's all you got to do is say fire, hallelujah, because you're in agreement with the woman of God, the servant of the Most High God. Oh my God. Hallelujah. Somebody may have been going through something all week long. You may have been in a battle. You may have been under attack. And tonight I'm here to let you know that you got the victory in Christ Jesus. Just open your mouth, hallelujah, and say fire. Hey, Kata, it's fire Friday. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I'm here to let you know why there's a sound that's going forth, and there's a word that is coming from heaven, that is coming from the Lord. It is now time to feast on that word, to get full on that word. Hallelujah. You can sit all day and you can get full off your Popeyes. You can get full off of your Kentucky Fried Chicken or your Publix Fried Chicken, but somebody got to get full off the word, because we can't live by bread alone, hakata, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. We need to be full, hallelujah. Just like we feed that flesh man, we got to feed that spirit man, hallelujah. And I'm here to let you know, that flesh man don't want you to pray, that flesh man don't want you to read that Bible, hallelujah. He don't want you to be in relationship and communication with God. But I'm here to let you know, hallelujah, humble yourself, hallelujah, and just go on your knees. And just make a sound, hallelujah, even if you got to go into a moan. Oh Lord, hey Lord, let me tell you, heaven knows what you're moaning about. Heaven knows what you're groaning about. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Somebody call fire. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. We're going to get started on tonight because there has to be a word, hallelujah, that's going to be the feast tonight, that we're going to feed upon tonight. Oh my God, hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lord. I'm going to go into prayer at this time. Hallelujah. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord God. Hallelujah, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, I ask God for forgiveness, God, of all my sins, oh God. Hallelujah. I pray that you would purify me, Father, and sanctify me, God, to enter into the courts of a holy king, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, I pray for your people on tonight, God. I pray that you would forgive them of their sins, oh God. I pray that you would have mercy on their lives, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, I pray that you will cover them, God, in the name of Jesus, and you will keep them, God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord God, tonight I pray for more mercy in this nation. I pray for more grace, God, in the name of Jesus, because we're in times that there is more sin, and Lord, we need you, God. Help us, Holy Ghost. We can't do it without you, God. In the name of Jesus. Lord, if you don't go before us, God, we don't know which way to go, God. In the name of Jesus, I pray for this country, God. I pray a blessing over this nation, God. In the name of Jesus, and I cancel every curse, God. In the name of Jesus, I cancel every activity, every assignment sent, hallelujah, to capture the souls of the saints, God. In the name of Jesus, and I loose your will, Father. I loose your will in earth, oh God, as it is in heaven, God. I loose it in Polk County. I loose it in Indian River County. Oh God, help us, God. Help us, Lord, on tonight. I pray for our leaders of this country, God. I pray for the president, the lawmakers, the lawbreakers. I pray tonight, God, for the armed forces. And God, I pray for, hallelujah, the policemen. Hallelujah, ha-yeka, throughout the nation, God, that you will keep them, that you will cover them, God. In the name of Jesus, I bind every satanic attack that is sent, hallelujah, to bring in an assignment that would be a war between the people of God, hallelujah, in the children of the darkness, God, in the name of Jesus. And I pray, God, that, hallelujah, your people will operate in wisdom, God, hallelujah, and they will be wise as serpents and harmless as doves on tonight, God, in the name of Jesus. And Father God, I thank you for hearing your servant on tonight. And I thank you for doing it on tonight, God. Great is thine faithfulness. Hallelujah. People of God, once again, thank you for tuning in to the broadcast with God's servant, Tammy Carter, located in Vero Beach, Florida. If you are in the need of prayer, you can contact me at 772-940-4126. Hallelujah. If you're in the need of deliverance, you can contact the same number, 772-940-4126. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If there's anything that's in your life that's troubling your life, hallelujah, glory be to God, and you are in the need of prayer, hallelujah, contact me. You can also go to the website. And the website address is www.firedeliverance.org. Hallelujah. Once again, that's www.firedeliverance.org. And you can contact me there. Hallelujah. We also have a monthly newsletter that goes out. Hallelujah. To inmates all over the world. So if you have anyone that you would like to add to the list that you would like us to send a letter out to, you can contact the ministry as well and provide that information, and we'll be sure to send out a newsletter, hallelujah, to your incarcerated loved one, or it may be you. You can be listening to the broadcast somewhere, hallelujah, in prison in the state of Florida, as all around the world. If you're tuning in to the broadcast via online. Hallelujah. Praise God for that. Tonight I want to speak on wisdom. Hallelujah, because it looks like the world has gone mad. Ha! Kata! Ho kata mayeka reshegata! Something is happening, hallelujah, in the spirit realm, but in the earthen realm, hallelujah, woo, something has been set off, and people are going off, hallelujah, and minds are running off, hallelujah, but we got to understand what can get this world back on track is a word from God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We have the word, and I'm going to go to the word on tonight. Glory be to God. And I'm going to start at 2 Timothy chapter 1 and verse 7. The Bible reads, "For God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love in a sound mind." Hallelujah. Oh, katamaye. See, we got to understand. Glory be to God. God has given us as the Bible says, not the spirit of fear, but of power. So he has given us the spirit of power, the spirit of love, and the spirit of a strong mind. So hallelujah, what's going on? A sound mind. So if we got a sound mind, what is going on? I want to deal with the church on tonight. Come on, somebody. We're listening, hallelujah, to people in the world telling us to defund the police. My God. Hallelujah. People who have security over their persons, over their homes, over their families, but they're telling you, my God, that you don't need the police. Glory be to God. So when they are up under attack, they have security. But we are out here, we the people, and they want us out here without security. That don't sound like a sound mind to me. That sounds like somebody that has lost their mind, but yet and still, you want to follow that sound. Glory be to God. That's leading you as sheep to the slaughter. My God, help us, Holy Ghost. We need you tonight, God. Can somebody call fire? Can somebody say, help us, God? Oh my God. Hallelujah. It's so much being said. Glory be to God. And none of it is making sense. But because of your hate for one person, and I'm going to say it for what it is, the president, you still want to hear and follow a sound that is leading you as sheep to the slaughter. Ekata. Come on, people of God. We're in the world, but we're not of the world, because we got a guide, and we can go to the word. Hallelujah. We can't operate in the flesh, but we got to operate in the word of God, because the Lord says that he has given us the power, he given us the spirits of power, love, and a sound mind. Come on, somebody. We got to understand that it's God that sets up and it's God that takes down. Hallelujah. He set kings up and he take them down. We don't understand it. Hallelujah. But it's his way. Come on, somebody. It's his will. Come on, somebody. And when you fight against his will, you're fighting against God. Ha! Yekata. Help us, Holy Ghost. Forgive us, Father. Glory be to God. We need wisdom. We need understanding in the spirit realm, not by what we see, by what we don't see. That lines up with the word of God. That lines up with truth. That's gonna cover us and shield us. And not going to lead us as sheep to the slaughter. 2 o'clock in the morning, you hear somebody breaking into your home. Who you going to call? You going to call your neighbor? They ain't coming. Because if both of y'all be up under attack, who y'all going to call? We talking about wisdom tonight. Glory be to God. Let's go to Proverbs, starting at chapter 1. The Bible reads, the Proverbs of Solomon, the son of David, king of Israel. To know wisdom and instruction, to perceive the words of understanding, to receive the instruction of wisdom, justice, and judgment, and equity, to give subtlety to the simple, to the young man knowledge and discretion. A wise man will hear and will increase learning, and a man of understanding shall attain unto wise counsels. Are you seeking wise counsel? See, we can seek counsel, but are we seeking wise counsel? Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Because of anybody telling you that you don't need security, you don't need the police, that's not wise counsel. Hallelujah. Do know and understand, as the word says, a wise man will hear and will increase in learning. See, that's what's wrong with the church. And the thing that I've seen, hallelujah, is that you got leaders that are preaching and teaching you, hallelujah, to go a certain way. Y'all need to vote for this person, even though this person is for homosexuality, therefore abortion, therefore just different things that are not of God. Therefore homosexuality, but they still preaching it in the pulpit. That's who you need to vote for. But God is over here saying, we're going to bring prayer back into schools. Huh? Because you got to understand there's two sides. And we can't look at it as political parties. We got to look at it as righteousness and judgment. We got to look at it as we want leadership that will govern and rule Hallelujah. So that there will be an inheritance for our children. Because we got to have order. We can't just allow anything to go. Next thing you'll see, it's okay for people to walk on the streets naked and do just any old thing that's warring against heaven. Again, we are spiritual beings, so it's what's inside of these people that are talking to you. And God is not going to lead you to what is not of him. That's going to have you to sin against heaven. We need some wisdom and understanding on tonight. Help us, God. Help us, Holy Ghost. My God. The Bible goes on to read, to understand a proverb and the interpretation, the words of the wise in their dark sayings. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. See, that's the problem. Don't nobody fear God anymore. They don't fear God. And even we have gotten to a place in the times that we're in that men don't fear authority anymore. And when people don't fear authority, then anything goes. And we can't have it that way. Hallelujah. People running around here like they are in a video game, destroying, killing, stealing, doing any old kind of thing. No, hallelujah, that's not of God. God is a God of peace. He's a God of love. He's a God of order. It may be tight, but it's right. You'll know them by the fruits that they bear. Not only that, you may look at a person and be like, well, he was X, Y, and Z, huh? But the Bible reads that Moses killed somebody and God called him. Glory be to God. Paul said he was a chief sinner, but God called him. My God. God can do anything. He can use anybody. As long as what they are doing is righteousness and judgment, you got to know that God is operating in that vessel and through that vessel. Because the enemy comes for the head. He wants the authority over the people. And if he got it in the head, the highest seat in the land, hallelujah. Then when his imps round here, these demons round here, all they things that they're trying to do, they have the authority to do it, and doors are being opened for them to go through it. But I'm here to let you know that God got people out here in the streets that are crying out truth. And I'm telling you that they're not in a pulpit. They are cussing, but they're crying out truth. Every word or every other word that may come out their mouth is a cuss word, but they're crying out truth. Hallelujah. If you won't speak it, I'm going to send somebody. Come on, somebody. People of God, know who God is. Understand his doings. Hallelujah. Get back into your word. Go back to the Old Testament and you'll know about God, the true and living God. Hallelujah. His ways are not like man's ways. Neither are his thoughts like man's thoughts. My God. Hallelujah. Go to the word and make sure when you hear a preacher preaching or teaching that what they're preaching and teaching is lining up with the word. Because everybody that rebelled against Moses, they were destroyed. And when sin was in the camp, hallelujah, the children of Israel were losing battle. God don't like sin. So if you choose somebody, a leader that's leading you to sin, you better believe God is not there. Well, people of God, I thank you once again for tuning in to the broadcast. This is God's servant, Tammy Carter, with Fire Deliverance Ministries. Hallelujah. Be encouraged. Hallelujah. And know tonight that Jesus loves you. And the woman of God loves you. Again, if you are in the need of prayer or deliverance, you can contact me at 772-940-4126 or via the website www.firedeliverance.org. God bless on tonight.